What an incredible season it was for the 97-98 edition of the Buffalo Sabres. Coach Lindy Ruff and his squad overcame a lot of hurdles and much adversity on their way to a Final Four appearance and a spectacular run at the Stanley Cup. Kick back, relax, and enjoy the Buffalo Sabres on their way to the National Hockey League semifinals.
Eric Plant's overtime goal against Ottawa took the Sabres to the highest point the team had been in years. However, the summer months that followed brought many unexpected lows.
I get knocked down, I get knocked down, I get knocked down, but I get up again, you're never gonna beat me down.
Critics questioned if the team would be able to get past the traumatic summer. The future looked grim when the Sabres fell to the 0-7 Chicago Blackhawks.
Yeah, you know, pressure, it's a strange thing, you know, it sits on the back of everybody's mind and they really don't know how to handle it sometimes, and I think last year when we came into training camp in September that there was a lot more pressure on us, you know, people were expecting a lot more.
The team finished November with a record of 7-12-5, winning only two of their final 10 games during the month. The idea of making the playoffs was slipping away faster and faster.
I get knocked down, I get knocked down, I get knocked down.
Through all the turmoil, the Dominator had become merely average. At the end of November, Don was ranked 33rd among NHL goalies. However, on December 1st, that would all change. Eric Lindros scored 19 minutes into the game. That was the last goal Dominik would allow for 176 minutes, which included 4-0 wins over the Mighty Ducks of Anaheim and the Tampa Bay Lightning.
So I think what really got the team started was the beginning of December, the way Dominik Hasek played. He's the guy that really gave the team the lift and got us on a roll.
You know, you're sitting there after the game and you just go, Dom, that was amazing, man. Like, that was, how did you do that? And, you know, he just sort of takes it in stride.
Hasek was named NHL Player of the Week with a 0.74 goals against average, a 97% save percentage, and two shutouts. The Dominator was back. December 19th, Montreal came to town. Dom turned back all 42 shots, setting a team record for most shots faced in a shutout. The Rangers would be Dom's next shutout victim, making that his second back-to-back perfect game of the month.
Right back in again, Lindholm, second shot. Oh, it came away. The Buffalo Sabres win the game. Dominik Hasek, he blanks another one.
5 days later, the Rangers came to Marine Midland Arena looking for revenge and were blanked again.
That run in December, he stood on his head for I don't know how many games in a row, and it was an incredible feat to watch. It wasn't a total team effort on some nights, it was just the Dominator.
December 31st, Ottawa was in town for Tucks and Pucks, but were shut out of the party 3-0. Shutout number 6 tied the NHL record for the most shutouts in a month and earned Hasek the Player of the Month honors. After the incredible run by Dominik Hasek in December with 6 shutouts, the team still only won 7 of 15 games in 97's final month and ended the year 5 games under 500, struggling to stay alive in the Eastern Conference playoff picture. With the new year came a new season. Hasek was at the top of his game again, and his teammates took notice.
Once Dominik was playing well, and, you know, his level came up so high that, you know, we just sort of followed behind him. You know, when he started playing well, we started playing well. You know, and he was a guy that raised his level to such a high level that, you know, it brought the rest of us with it. It's the same, you know, they always talk about, you bring the level of your game to the level you're playing with. And, you know, that's what happened. He was the guy that more or less carried this team.
Dominik carried them through a spectacular second half of the season that set the stage for a great playoff run. The Sabres own the best record in the National Hockey League since January 1st, winning or tying 33 of 43 games for a wonderful 64% winning percentage. The second half surge took the team from 5 games under 500 to 7 over and a 6th-place finish in the Eastern Conference. Buffalo strung together a 13-game unbeaten streak that included an unblemished mark in February, as well as a remarkable 8-game unbeaten road streak.
As a group of guys, we got back to playing it like a team like we did the year before. And we got on a roll and we got some confidence. And when you get that, it's very easy to go out and for a 2-week stretch and only lose one game and then look back and say, wow, we just lost one game. You don't really think about it. But when you're on a roll and you're confident and you're just playing and playing and playing, that's what happens. And we just got to the point where every time we put on our skates to go out and play, we expected to win and we wanted to win. And most of the times we did win.
I think every night a different guy stepped up to the plate and either scored a winning goal through a winning check or a dominator coming through in nets. And I just think it was an all-around team effort, and the peer pressure, I think, from everyone within the room had an important role in that.
Included in the all-around team effort was the maturation of the youngest team in the NHL, and in particular, 3 kids who were getting their first dose of regular ice time.
Well, Curtis Brown, even before this year, I don't think you could have ever met a more mature 21-year-old. You know, for him to go through some times during the season where he was a healthy scratch, but could have easily been in the lineup, he realized the situation and was disappointed, but stayed positive and really benefited himself and our team in the long run. And Virata, who finally got his chance when Jason Dahl was traded, and seemed to add something to our line that we really enjoyed, and that was kind of guy that got in your face and was cut and stitched all the time and just annoyed everybody, I guess is the best way to put it, and really added some clutch scoring for us in certain times. And Wayne Primo's a kid who's just, been maturing a little bit every year, and it really came into his own towards the end of the year and helped us down through the playoffs in certain situations. He was one of our key face-off guys, and the organization's pretty happy to see 3 young, mature guys like that come along.
What was very important to this hockey club last year was the development of Primo and Brown and Virata into full-time NHL players. And not only were they full-time NHL players, but they made a very significant contribution to the success of this hockey club last year.
Speaking of young but mature guys, 25-year-old Alexei Zhitnik enjoyed a breakthrough season as the backbone of the Sabres defense and elevated himself to the upper echelon of NHL defensemen.
I think he really took pride in his plus-minus. And obviously he's an offensive type defenseman, and he loves to see points, but he took more pride in seeing his plus-minus improve. And I think that helped his overall game. He takes a ton of pride on shutting a best player, like the other team's best player, down. There's not too many guys around that can take the puck out of the zone the way Z can. And he really has come on. And when you have a guy that can play 30 minutes on the back end, it makes a big difference to your hockey team.
There's more to our defense than just Zitnik. We relied on a lot of guys, Shannon, who probably isn't the prettiest guy in the world to watch play, but he's very effective. Shan's been bounced around a little bit, but I believe he's found a nice home here. We play him in all situations, and he did a great job for us, and he was our highest plus-minus leader on the team. Schmelnik, another guy that fans have a tendency to get on him a little bit, but Schmelnik, he's a horse out there. He's kind of one of those guys that throw back the old days, like a Bill Height. He's not the fastest skater, he's not the strongest, he's a big guy, and it has a tendency for people to get on him, but Schmelly's very effective.
I thought that we had come too far in the 3 months to be thrown in against one of the best teams in the league.
We were ready to face Philly. We had something that we felt we owed them from last year.
we felt we deserved that series last year as much as they did, and I think we had something to prove.
Buffalo dominated the first two periods behind goals by Michael Groshek and Wayne Primo, along with a rugged physical defense anchored by Dominik Hasek. The favored Flyers, however, were not going to go quietly.
Once Philadelphia tied it, it seemed as though they thought they didn't win hockey than were our guys. You can see the upset and determined look on the bench that, they wanted to win this game. They weren't going to come in here and let this team come back from 2-0 and beat them.
Back to the point. Boomer, a shot. Rebound. Odette scores!
That first game was probably the most important game for us, to be able to bounce back after letting them tie it up and come out with the win was extremely important for us and gave us all kinds of confidence.
Game two featured the brutal hitting that would set the tone for the series. And though the game would end in a bitter 3-2 defeat, the Sabres left Philadelphia confident.
We knew at that point, before that game ended, that we had the ability to beat them every time we stepped on the ice again.
Coming home to our fans here, that was going to be worth at least one win and possibly two, that in the last 3 months of the season, the fans had made a huge difference, and we knew they'd be ready for game three at home.
You know, our guys seemed to really get up for it, and when we came out of the gate hard and showed the same intensity and the same work ethic, it just seemed to discourage them. They just didn't have a plan to counteract it.
I remember after the first period, our guys just knew, for some reason, we knew that we had them, because we just never backed down, and we just kept on going through them. Not just hitting them, we were going through them.
We came up flying. Just charged, and it was amazing. Just boom, 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 boom. I think it was 6-1, and it was a lot of fun. We enjoyed it. After game three, then it was going to be back to real tight, real tough kind of game where we're going to have to really battle one out. And next thing you know, boom, 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 we're up 4-1 again. We're all looking at each other going, well, how did this happen?
You sat on the bench and you just kind of looked in their eyes. And as they were coming off, you know, with Dominik stoning them and they're coming off shaking their heads. And, you know, they had guys laying all over the ice that were hurt because our guys were going at them so much and wearing them down.
By that point in the series, I mean, the confidence in our locker room was just incredible. And the speed that we knew we possessed was really dominating the series and just wanted to go up the same game, and we did that.
We all knew it was Groshek going to score the goal before it happened. He had so many opportunities in the third period to put it away, breakaway after breakaway, post after post. And we told him before overtime started he was going to be the hero and he was going to be the one to score the goal. And he kind of stood up and said, yeah, it's going to be me.
Beating Philadelphia was probably the most gratifying thing so far, you know, with this team that I've gone through, you know, sitting back and getting the last laugh on a team that is, you know, did it to us three or four other times in my career, that, you know, it was pretty neat to see them kind of with their heads down, skating off the ice, and we were the ones celebrating.
After that first period, probably thought that we were going to sail through. You know, we thought we got through the Philadelphia Flyers with ease, and why would the Montreal Canadiens give us any trouble? And almost bit us in the butt. You know, if it wasn't for Dom coming up with his best performance in the playoffs at that time, you know, who knows what would have happened in that series? But we hung in there, and sometimes in the playoffs, that's going to happen. You're not going to play great every game, and Dom was there to play great for us, and